men are in the 240-mile AuSable Canoe Marathon. Behind them, screaming in the background, are their support teams, their families, their friends, their loved ones who will follow them the 240 miles from Grayling to Oscoda down on Lake Huron. It's the longest, toughest, most grueling marathon endurance event in North America. That's what the racers say. What's it like? Well, they say it's like standing in front of a huge mountain of sand with a wide shovel and shoveling a shovel full every second for 15 hours and as fast as you can back over your shoulder. That's what it's like to pull on this AuSable River and hope to finish in 15 or 16 hours. We're going to follow them on this edition of Sports Afield. Once away from the exciting starting line, the crowd start to thin out, and the racers are alone in their agony. In these annual marathon races, usually about half will not even complete the run. Illness, cramps, accidents, and the simple torture of it will knock out all but the most dedicated racers. Also dedicated are the bank runners, the support teams who carry easy-to-digest foods and liquids. Without nourishment, the paddlers wither and fade fast. The racers come from all walks of life to test themselves, to find out their real limits. Earlier at the start area, I spoke with some of the contenders to find out more about them. Berlin Kruger from Lansing, Michigan is the oldest racer at age 57. His stern person is 26-year-old Bev Feldspaugh, also from the Lansing area. She's a physical therapist. I asked about their race plan.
Positive mental attitude. It takes a lot of, if you can build yourself up, I think, mentally, it takes a lot mentally, as much as it does physically.
Then I talked with French-speaking Claude Corbin of Quebec and his brother, Serge. I did learn from Claude that this handsome young electrician does all this for recreation and the fun of competition. Claude says his strategy for the marathon is simple. Stay behind the fastest local team through the night and then pass them just before the finish line.
Jay, what you've been telling us about racing is fascinating. But
Jay Stefan, last year's AuSable champion, is a native of Grayling. His father won this race several times. Jay was ill this year, so he didn't enter. But he has a marathon technique that is akin to self-hypnosis.
You say you go to sleep, but you continue paddling all the time.
Yeah, it's just like your subconscious is running your body, and you're letting the main parts of your brain sleep, so that once your brain gets rested, it becomes stronger than your body. And you don't know fatigue. It's just like you started the race all over again. You just wake up just like you got 8 hours sleep.
Back out on the Black River, it takes the leaders 5 hours to reach the first portage at Mayo Dam. Friends and family are not permitted to touch the canoes, but they can clear the way for the competitors. There is no way, however, that the supporters can alleviate the psychological agony that the paddlers all suffer.
To me, I'm not nervous about the race in itself when it starts. I think I'm more afraid of coming to that point where I say I want to stop. You know, I've gotten tired, but I've never really said, you know, I want to stop. But in this canoe race, I've always, in the 6 or 7 years that I've finished it, I've always wanted to stop at one time or another. And
this is 33-year-old Butch Stockton, a school teacher from Central Michigan. He's the chairman of the marathon, and he voices a common theme among the racers.
And I just kind of resign myself to a little prayer and say, well, I hope my body holds together again this year.
About 12 hours after the start of the marathon, after racing throughout the night, the leaders in canoe number 77 are John Baker from Grayling in the bow and his teenage partner, Ken Brown from St. Clair Shores. Seconds behind them are the brothers from Quebec, Claude and Serge Corbin.
Oh man, they've all
lost quite a bit of time there. Well, yeah, but that could be made up for the next dam, too, if something happens.
This is the final portage before the dash down the lower stretch of this famous AuSable River toward Oscoda on the shores of Lake Huron. The strategy of the Canadians seems to be working. They have been following Baker and Brown, the Michigan racers, who know the river well, and they are exactly where they said they wanted to be, right behind the leaders. Looking pale and haggard, Butch Stockton has been sick during the night. His partner, Bob Welsh from Detroit, pleads with him to give up, but Butch refuses to quit. Racers will lose about 1 pound of their body weight for each hour of tortuous paddling. They must take nourishment, and Butch has been unable to assimilate any food or drink. Farther downriver, the Canadian team keeps up their paddling at a fantastic rate of 80 strokes per minute. They're pouring it on at an unbelievable pace, closing the small gap and overtaking the leading Michigan team. Rounding the curve, they electrify the crowd by slipping into the lead position. And his brother Serge have come 240 miles in 14 hours, 40 minutes, and 29 seconds. They are just 20 seconds off the all-time AuSable Marathon record pace. In third place are a pair of rugged teenagers from North Central Michigan, Steve Krantz of Tawas and Brett Stockton from Grayling. Brett is Butch Stockton's nephew. This is an accomplishment they'll remember the rest of their lives. Close behind are Butch Stockton and Bob Welsh. Butch makes it all the way, his mental powers conquering physical illness. It will take several days for him to recover.
He should have pulled out of the race. Should have pulled out a mile. Should have pulled out a mile.
He was
sick all night long.
I don't even remember going over Mayo Dam.
57-year-old Berlin Kruger wins the 14th spot with Bev Feldspaugh, the only woman to finish. Of the 36 starters last night, only 20 will make it to this finish line.
I guess with all the noise in the crowd and the PA system, this is as good a place as any to try to wrap up the story on the 240-mile AuSable Canoe Marathon here in Michigan. A fantastic feat of endurance, the toughest marathon of its kind in the world. And we're proud to have been a part of it and bringing it to you here on Sports Afield.